Turn me up a little bit.
I'm down here at the local grocery store, and I'm looking to get me a turkey breast. I came over and I saw these here, which for the price is not bad, $10.99. It's a turkey breast roast, but I don't think it has the skin on it. Maybe I need to ask the butcher, or maybe just read. But we'll see. But the end, I think I'm gonna end up going with this one here, Genio. I'm looking for a natural turkey, but as you can see by probably right here, it has 19% solution of turkey broth, salt, sugar, and sodium phosphate and flavor. I'm still gonna inject this breast with maybe some Creole butter, or I'll make some flavored butter myself with some unsalted butter, some thyme, some basil, some sage, some garlic, some onions. Strain it out and inject it in the bird. But I think this will be the one I'm gonna get. So I ended up getting the Genio because the sales lady couldn't tell me if the other one had skin on it or not, and I really wanted skin. So I got this thing. This thing weighs about 6 pounds. I'm gonna thaw it out because I want to cook it tomorrow. Typically, with these turkeys, you put them in the refrigerator for like 1 or 2 days or until they thawed out. So if it's your first time doing a turkey, don't go out and buy a frozen turkey on Wednesday and think you're gonna be ready to cook it on Thursday. So we're gonna put it in my Cambro because I didn't want to put it in my sink. I have my sink tied up all day. So I'm gonna just continue to change off the water probably every hour. Put some cold water here, put the turkey, let it thaw. In an hour, I change the water out. We fill this thing up with water, and we're gonna let it ride, and tomorrow we're gonna put it on the Traeger. I'm thinking what I'm gonna inject this with. I may go with some Creole butter, because I'm just kinda lazy. End up putting a plate on top of this and keep it down. And I'll probably take about an hour or so, maybe an hour and a half, change the water out. If I keep this up, I'm pretty sure by the morning time, it should be thawed out and ready. All right, I got the turkey pretty much defrosted. It took me about, I'd say 3 hours maybe. It's 3 o'clock now, put it in probably about 1 o'clock. This is some cold water. I change the water out every hour. Now I'm just gonna let it sit in the freezer to stay safe or out the danger zone until I can get ready to prepare. Here's the brine kit that I got from my local grocery store here. This thing is super simple and it didn't cost a lot. I think it cost like 10 bucks. It came with the brine solution, the brine bag, if you don't have a Cambro or anything like that, and it came with the season. I didn't use any of my own season. I used everything that came with the kit, and this thing came out phenomenal. And I also injected with the Creole butter. I really like using this Creole butter because I like the taste of it. It doesn't add too much salt to your meat, and it keeps it super moist. I'm preparing the brine solution. It's very simple. You just take the instructions say you take a quart of water, and then you put it on the stove and you get it hot. And then you see I add a gallon of cold water to it. And you always gotta remember never to put your bird in hot water. You always wanna make sure it's cool. Put it in the refrigerator. But I just opted to put ice inside of mine so it'll cool it down, and when I stirred it and once that melted, I was good to go. I apologize for the lost footage of me removing the turkey out of the brine, and I did no more than remove it out of the brine. I rinsed out the inner cavity and then patted the bird dry. I used a seasoning packet that came with the brine kit, hit it with a little olive oil, and then sprinkled the seasoning onto the bird. Additionally, also what it's not shown here, is I spatchcocked the chicken breast too because I wanted to increase the surface area so I can cook it quicker. But once again, I apologize for the lost footage, but that's what I did in that period of time. All right, I'm gonna be cooking this on my Traeger tailgater today. We're gonna be running this at 300 degrees. I got my smoke tube here as well to add a little extra smoke because I found out that with pellet grills that when you're cooking at a high degree, you don't get the actual smoke. So we're gonna light the pellet tube and go ahead and heat up this Traeger to 300. I experienced something a little bit different this cook. And like I say, each cook is different. You're going to not have the same result on each cook. I noticed that on this side, my turkey breast was a little, a few degrees higher than this side. So I rechecked with another thermometer. And on this tailgater right here, it's a little hotter right here, and it's also a little hotter in the back. So what I did is I just reorientated my meat and I flipped it around. So this side right here will catch up. This is probably reading about 162. This is about 157, whatever. It's kind of strange, I know. But you gotta know the temperature of the meat. And if you know you got hot spots on your grill, orientate your meat as needed. Here's the finished product. Came out good too. I'm gonna let it rest for about 15 minutes. Then we're gonna go ahead and get some slices. All right, let's get into cutting this bad boy. See what we got. That's still nice and juicy.
Wow! I feel good.
That's just burnt on after burnt. Tender. Flavor all through the bone. That's the way to go. You do know about that. That's good. All right, this is meat stall. Find some meat and smoke it.
Okay. Turn me up a little bit.